Welcome back. This is the RPG check. We're at Cragholdt Bluffs. This was a big, huge battle here. And we've had several other battles with ancient death guards and Al Ghul, and yeah, pretty crazy. Something here we can collect.
Got it.
Blood moss. Yummy. Just like Mom and me, a little blood moss pie. Yeah, this place has seen better days, I think. Let's see how far we can go before we run into more death knights and ghoul thingies. Location discovered, Cragholdt. This boulder appears to have crashed through the tower, taking a section of the wall with it. Alright. They've been using siege weapons here. And I guess just here. To attack this place. And yeah, they're messing stuff up. Yeah, let's go this way. Let's check out this fountain. Or what remains of it. There's a dead person and a hidden thing. Let me guess. Happened last time. There was a hidden thing that we could see, but the game then acted like all of a sudden we could see it. If it happens again, you'll see what I'm talking about. See? Something over there.
And the fire shows me something new.
Yeah. 5 golden obols. I know we've been using these. 2, 5. Gnats buzz over a film of murky, algae-choked water. Something glints just beneath the surface. Well, we can't walk on this, but somehow we can reach this. A topaz and a pearl. Grab that. And what else? What else is here? We can't go that way, so let's go this way. It's Cragholdt itself. Let's look for hidden stuff. Oh, we forgot to collect something. A bone and 26 gold. That bone, though, is another boulder. This boulder appears to have been crashed through the tower, taking a section of the wall with it. I think that's a duplicate description there. Anything secret here? Nope. Now we can't go this way at all, which is interesting. Okay, looks like this is the only way up then. Interesting how we go upstairs. We go quicker. It's almost like the illusion of stairs. It makes us look like we're going faster because we're really just going straight across the ground. If that makes any sense to you guys. I don't know if we can actually step over there at all at any point. Kind of wondering if we can. Pretty. Can't see all of it, but pretty. Oh, Oh, that's, we've killed all the enemies in this zone. Interesting. Yeah. We know this. Well, we only have one left. We probably should. Aloth's a little messed up. I should rest, but we only have one, so... If I find another camping supply, we'll rest. As it is, we're auto-saving now, so that's good. I've entered Cragholdt. Council Hot is around here somewhere. Grand adventure. Zawa. Okay. Oh, all these books. Look at this. Looky that. Nice. The shelves of this bookcase overflow with books, loose pages, and miscellaneous artifacts. Many of the spines you can see are scrawled with indecipherable glyphs, and more are completely blank. A proper search of this mess would probably take hours. You know that? And I'd probably do it too if it was, this was me. Search the bookcase. One of the books is especially heavy. Pulling it out, you see that it's a book on coinage with an assortment of actual coins. Pasted to the pages. You peel the coins away and take them. Oh god, what are we, a bunch of beggars? Hours of searching leave your back aching and your eyes sore. You don't find anything else of value. I wonder if hours have really passed in the game. As far as I can see, this is all currency that we're familiar with. Well, hours later. Oops, not sneaking anymore.
I'm freshly greased.
Scroll of Protection and Nass Attack Poetry, a compilation, which we already have, I believe. Protection. I think we're gonna get stacked by 5, yep. Just checking, okay. Nass Attack Poetry. I forget. Was it a blue book? I didn't really take note. If I just look for any book that has 2... Yes, okay. We have read this. Loving the library. Yep. Continuing. Having a blast. We're almost done. Hello? Cragholdt, I presume? Nope. Thrall Assassin. A man totters toward you as if drunk. He stops a few feet in front of you and looks at a point over your shoulder with wide glazed eyes. Tanas must speak with you, elf. Come, come. I was greeted by a servant of Tanas. His master wants to meet with me. Who's Tanas again?
Slowly now.
Go on ahead without me. I want to see what's in here. What the hell? Animated wands? What? Uraki? And wands? Oh. Animated spears? Poleaxe? What the hell's going on in here? The shelf has been nicked and notched all along its length. If I start going in stuff, I guess we'll just talk to him and then he'll be angry at us and make the things attack us.
Watch it! Distract me again and you're like to lose an eye.
Even as she speaks, the Omawa looks not at you, but at a row of weapons laid out on a table. Aren't you concerned about the siege outside?
Cragholdt hasn't even bothered to come out of his study since the attack started, so why should I worry?
She cringes and shakes her head.
Need something? I'm still busy here.
She places a dagger on a scale and scrawls a note on the parchment beside her. What are you doing?
Cataloging weights, centers of gravity. Controlling a 3.5-foot blade in the air is harder than it looks.
Haha. She balances a sword between her index fingers and jots a note. Who else is in Cragholdt?
Aside from me, there are 3 other apprentices working on their own projects. I don't know anything about Sobble or Peldon, but stay away from Tanos, the Vithrek. There's something about him I don't trust.
Huh. Well, we're supposed to go meet with him. Tell me about Cragholdt.
He's not someone you want to cross. Or disappoint. You know, I really should get back to work.
She scratches the back of her head. I'm surprised I'm allowed to wander so freely.
If Cragholdt didn't want you here, you'd have known it the moment you came down those stairs. And then you'd be dead. If you were lucky.
All right, goodbye.
I can do that. That's settled.
I see what's in here. Oh. Missed him, though. Surprised he didn't, 500 gold, yeah, it's not worth it. The white that wins. Yeah, we don't need any of this stuff. Eh. Ooh.
Now this I haven't seen before.
Nice, another one of those ebony spider figurines and 3 Durgan ingot. I really want the ingot, actually.
My eyes are peeled.
Her back is to us. Maybe these weapons see us.
What?
Exceptional wand. Scroll of Mineletta's concussive missiles. A potion of lockpick. 5 lockpicks, actually. Uriaki's research notes. I won't take them, but I'll read them. The enchantment duration on the animated weapons remains inconsistent. I've ruled out weapon type and material, but it's frustrating when the exact procedure on identical weapons yields different results. The smell from Peldon's lab doesn't help things either. The elders are counting on me to alter the balance of power on the isle in our tribe's favor. If I don't return home with a reliable army of weapons, it may be better never to return at all. Well, I don't want to steal from the guy. What'd she say again? Why should we worry about it? All right. Yeah, come on, guys. If we get a Vithrak brain from this guy, we can enchant another thing. This Thanos or whatever the hell. Hear things running. Let's see what other wonders we'll find. Oh, there's an Al Ghul. Friendly Al Ghuls? Oh, is this Peldon? The creature in the tank remains still, but its eyes follow you as you get close. We didn't get close. There's no movement from the creature inside this tank. And this one? An Amawa-sized creature floats in the tank. Its flesh is shriveled and gray. Hail. The laboratory reeks of rotting flesh, but the elf doesn't seem to notice. He's busy writing notes into a small book, and he doesn't even look up as you approach. But he frowns when your shadow falls across his page. Let me guess, he's annoyed with being interrupted again as well?
Stand back, ghoul. I'll summon you when I have need of you.
He points to a dim corner of the laboratory. If you say so, but don't you want to know how I taught myself to speak? He finally looks up at you, startled and irritated.
Effigy's eyes, who are you?
He shakes his head and waves a hand, nearly grazing you with his pen.
I don't have time for this. Get out of here and leave me to my work, all right?
He returns to his notes before you can even answer. What are you doing here?
I'm researching a complex problem for one of the greatest wizards ever to have lived, and I certainly haven't the time to explain it to you. Go.
He dismisses you with a flick of his wrist. His nose is still buried in his book. These ghouls are different, more docile, and less rotten.
I should hope so. I've been trying to stabilize them, prevent them from decaying further.
He looks at you out of the corners of his eyes.
Of course, the process is not yet complete.
Can you tell me anything about Cragholdt? He glances up long enough to shoot you a suspicious glare.
If you've never studied his repertoire of spellwork, never read of his accomplishments in Maestra Albena's Histories of Modern Magic, and somehow missed the small army he's held back outside, then no, I don't know what to tell you.
Huh.
Except that he's a powerful wizard with little patience.
He licks his thumb and turns a page. What do you know about Cragholdt?
Why must you bother me with such inane questions? Go interrupt one of the other apprentices.
Done
Their
that.
Time is much less valuable than mine.
I don't think they would agree with that. Alright, what stuff can we look at?
Shh.
Don't get in our way as we're sneaking around looking for stuff. See if this is trapped. Next thing might not be.
I can do that.
Now, I guess they don't care that we unlock things. Rugged wilderness hat. Plus one constitution and plus two survival. Those willing to brave the wild places beyond the boundaries of civilization soon find themselves hardier for their efforts. It is a journey reflected in this battered but sturdy cap. Through harsh weather and the deadliest of circumstances, this hat will keep one's head warm. Glamfellen and stalking boots. These boots are worn by Glamfellen hunters and warriors when stalking prey or foes, respectively. Why do you have to actually add in respectfully if there's nothing? Never mind. Peldon's research notes. As if I'd leave notes on my experiments for anyone to find, but while you're reading this, Urariki, however you say it, if one of your weapons wanders in here again, I'm keeping it. Sable, I've never talked to you, but stay out of my lab anyway. Tanos, I doubt you can even read, but I'm feeding your minions to my test subjects the next time I catch one of them loitering outside my lab. That's funny. Greetings. The algal bares its teeth but says nothing. So that's it, huh? Alright.
Quickly and quietly.
Yeah, don't go that quickly. Still hear those things scampering around. There's a lever that opens something. Void Seer? What? What is this thing? It's a Void Seer. Oh, I hear whispering. Silence! Do not disturb the apprentices. That's a talking mouth type door. You see no keyhole in the door. Yet a voice booms from the other side, almost as if the speaker were standing right in front of you. Your master awaits a worthy pupil. Let the apprentice who has perfected a spell and gathered the lessons of her fellows speak her purpose. Alright, so... Cragholdt's in there? Let me go there last. I want to explore this entire place first before we... end off there.
Good thing I'm freshly greased.
Mm-hmm. Oh, dead end? Okay, let's check this other hallway. Ooh, there's a goodie there. Oh, there's a door there. Hello?
Yeah?
Hold up. You come seeking Cragholdt's favor?
My eyes are peeled.
Yeah, let's go in here. Maybe not while someone can see us. Okay.
A simple test. That's settled.
Oh! Owie?
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Wait till this thing goes away.
Aye?
The apprentices grow restless. Dangerous.
Nice and quiet.
What?
At least we didn't get hit by another energy bolt. Lightning bolt.
And the fire shows me something new. What?
Is this trap too? Yes, it is.
A simple test.
Oh boy.
A simple test.
What about that one? Yeah, that one's a little bit of a simple test.
A simple test.
The Last Tower, which is a shield, a iridescent scarab figurine, and 58 of these Adra Eniac. Coins. The Last Tower. So it's a large shield. We don't use large shields. We have two of us who use medium ones. 16 deflection minus 8 accuracy. It's exceptional, so it's got plus 8 shield deflection, plus 1 move speed. Grants armor of faith. 3 per rest. Which is a plus 4 damage reduction. According to legend, this shield was one of 12 fashioned for a small subset of paladins from the Order of Kind Wayfarers. Calling themselves the Towers, the paladins charged themselves with protecting the small outlying villages and towns clustered along the foothills of the White March. Though their numbers were few, the paladins were known for their unwavering dedication, moving swiftly to engage any threat to innocent travelers. Those with the fortune to fight beside these warriors often said that they felt as if otherwise fatal blows would glance harmlessly off their armor, and claimed that the paladins had brought them fortune. As the years passed, each of the paladins succumbed to age or violence until only one remained. The last tower became a legendary figure in her own right, walking a lonely patrol along the eastern roads of the Deerwood. This shield is said to have been pulled from the Lake of Drowned Tombs by a villager from Good Hope. The battered kite shield remains a fine piece of craftsmanship, though the green paint of its heraldic tower has been scraped away in several places. What about these things? Bunch of Adra bands and Adra. So naughty for stealing this stuff. 5 opals and 5 pearls. Boom, boom. Watch, he'll know that we'd, like, took it. Somehow.
A simple test.
Right here. If you say so.
She can't do that.
What?
How many of these things does he have? 3 more? I usually just trip it off, but let's... let's do it this way.
Hmm? A simple test.
Trap disarmed.
I can do that.
Now unlocked. Exceptional battle axe, 5 sapphires, 4 rubies, 3 emeralds, 3 topaz, 3 diamonds, and 103 gold. That's freaking awesome. Nice. Yes.
You can trust me.
Yes, we can count on you. That was awesome. Let's go this way. Ooh, who's rattling the chains? Did that disturb the apprentices? Well, this door is open. Who's this? That's all these Vithraks are. Let's go this way first. Steel Spine Magus. 2 of them. There's a Sable. Another Steel Spine Magus. Books. Goodies. The dwarf whirls to face you. Her face and throat are twisted with fresh scar tissue. Her remaining eye narrows as she assesses you. Out! Her voice is little more than a croak as she points you to the door. Attack. What are you working on? She hisses and gestures angrily at the door. I just have a few questions. She holds up her right hand, 3 fingers extended. As you watch, she lowers one, then another. She looks from you to the door. I really want to see what happens at 3. The woman snarls and reaches for a grimoire. Okay, if that's the way you want it.